a brief description of Thyestes. It's a play about two brothers who begin a lifelong rivalry very early on in their childhood. It continues and descends into a bitter feud with no holds barred until the unspeakable occurs.
You chose now to do this.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck you!
What's the matter?
Fuck you! This is not the time or place!
What do you mean?
The central event of the play is this dinner scene where, in revenge of his brother sleeping with his wife, Atreus feeds his brother his own children.
So him kill the dog in the creek.
Like a stray dog?
Yeah, stray dog.
Yeah, he's planning to eat it?
No, they put your food over there.
Right.
We were less interested, given that there is so much baggage around that event, in really exploding, in really kind of focusing on that event, than exploding everything around it and why anyone could possibly do that and what the effects of having that done to you would be.
I got a lot of love for you, especially my brother. And I got a lot of love for you, especially my lover. You're my family. This one's for you, okay?
In terms of writing a new version of Seneca, the thing that we were most interested in was the series of events that this horrific family feud had in it, and then finding a way of presenting similar events in a contemporary context. I think you should say, because I got myself one of those Twitter accounts before I left, so I tweeted her.
I tweeted her.
I'm coming in October, not September. That's what she tweeted.
We have been adding improvisations. It's generally me coming into the room and saying, yeah, keep that bit, change that bit, yeah, keep that bit. And often I'll come back 3 days later and some wonderful conversation has sprouted. And I've got to prune it, inevitably, to make sure it stays very healthy and clear. It's an exciting process in terms of developing text. Yeah, go for the little pour into his, yeah. If that happens, I would try and then tip some in during your story. And try and get it exactly even while you tell the story.
So it's just regular guys kind of standing around in shorts and singlets and stuff.
Yeah, like it? Sunglasses and shotguns kind of thing.
Yeah, exactly.
I think comedy is essential to making tragedy work. If you haven't invested in the lightness of a story, there's no way that you'll accept its darkness or be moved by its darkness. The story is essentially about a family with a few psychological problems at its core, like all families have. And I suppose the play is then essentially about two people trying to escape the inevitability that their own lives will also be screwed up. There's a lot of scenes where a curtain comes up on a moment that has just been violent or goes down just before the violence happens, so that there is a kind of dance between the suspense of watching a horrific moment, expecting to watch a horrific moment, and then not seeing it, not seeing it, not seeing it, not seeing it, and then eventually seeing it in an unexpected way rather than the predictability and gratuitousness of, I suppose, kind of more in-your-face pieces of theatre or film. Thank you.